Hello everyone, in this session we'll be starting with the lower limb muscles from the anatomy decoded notes that we have made for you all. Okay, so in this particular session we'll be covering the anterior compartment of the thigh as well as the anterior muscles of the hip. Okay, so this image shows the muscles of the entire lower limb in an anterior view as well as posterior view. We can see the right sided lower limb seen in an anterior view, right sided lower limb in a posterior view. Okay. So muscles in the anterior compartment of the thigh are present in this region, okay, and muscles in the anterior aspect of the hip are present in this region. Okay, so total how many muscles are to be learnt in upper limb? Do you have any idea? Yes, total 59 muscles to be learnt in lower limb, out of which muscles in the anterior compartment of the thigh will be learning 7 muscles, and anterior aspect of the hip there are 3 muscles. Okay. And there is one summary video of the entire 59 muscles also available on this channel. If time permits, please watch that video as well. And in this particular video, I have incorporated cadaveric images, concise notes of particular regions. Okay. So let's start with the anterior compartment of the thigh now. So here we can see the muscles of the anterior compartment of the thigh. So one by one, let us just see the location of these muscles, and then individual muscles will be learning in details in the form of 4 headings: origin, insertion, nerve supply, action. Okay, so the first muscle that we'll be learning is this sartorius muscle. Okay, a muscle which is present obliquely in the anterior aspect of the thigh. It is the longest muscle of the body, arising from this part of the hip bone called as anterior superior iliac spine and going up to the tibia. Okay, this muscle is sartorius. Then we'll be learning a group of muscle called as quadriceps femoris. Okay, so quadriceps femoris includes 4 muscles. One is rectus femoris, then vastus lateralis, vastus medialis, and a muscle which is deep to rectus femoris. That muscle is shown here. This is vastus intermedius. Okay, so these 4 muscles together are referred to as quadriceps femoris. Okay. And in this image that we can see, only the central part is vastus intermedius. Okay, this muscle is vastus medialis, this muscle is vastus lateralis. In between them here, that's the vastus intermedius. Okay, so quadriceps femoris 4, sartorius 15, and we can see one muscle here, tensor fascia lata. Okay, muscle present on the lateral aspect of the thigh. Okay, so but it is seen on the anterior aspect when we do dissection of this region, so that's why I've included this muscle here. Okay, in most of the books this muscle is included in the gluteal region because of the nerve supply. Okay, it receives nerve supply similar to the muscles of the gluteal region. Okay, and apart from that, there is one more muscle deep to vastus intermedius along the lower part of the femur. Okay, a muscle arises deep to vastus intermedius. That muscle is called as articularis genu. Okay, articularis genu. Okay, so like this there are 7 muscles. Let's see one by one now. So here this table summarizes all 7 muscles with their origin, insertion, nerve supply, action, along with the cadaveric image. Okay, so basically you should have knowledge of the cadaveric image, because in practical exams you will be having the cadaver in which you will have to identify the muscle, right? So let's start with the first muscle, sartorius. What is the origin? That we have seen, anterior superior iliac spine. Insertion is in the upper medial aspect of the tibia. Nerve supply is femoral nerve, and action is flexion at the hip joint as well as flexion at the knee joint. Okay, so it is flexing both the hip joint as well as the knee joint. Okay, then next muscle is rectus femoris. Okay, if you see these 4 muscles, rectus and the 3 vasti all together are referred to as quadriceps femoris. Okay, so if you see, some features would be similar. For example, quadriceps femoris all are having this nerve supply as femoral nerve. All will have one action like extension at the knee joint. Okay, you see insertion, that will also be similar. Okay, so some things are similar here. So let's start one by one. Rectus femoris, it is a muscle having two headed origin, that it has a straight head of origin, it has a reflected head of origin. Okay, straight head arises from anterior inferior iliac spine, reflected head arises from the ilium just above the acetabulum. Okay, there is a gluteal surface of the ilium just above the acetabulum. In that surface, the rectus femoris arises. Okay, insertion is the quadriceps femoris tendon, which goes to the base of the patella. And rectus femoris is causing flexion at the hip joint and extension at the knee joint. Okay, sartorius was causing flexion at hip and flexion at knee. Okay, rectus femoris is flexion at hip and extension at the knee. Okay, and then vastus medialis arises from the medial part of intertrochanteric line as well as the medial lip of linea aspera. Okay, these are the parts in the femur, intertrochanteric line, and linea aspera is present on the posterior aspect. Then its insertion is again as the quadriceps femoris tendon to the medial border of the patella. Okay, it has got extensive attachment on the medial border of patella. Nerve supplies femoral nerve. Action is extension of the leg at the knee joint. Okay, then vastus lateralis, again arising from the femur, lateral part of the intertrochanteric line, as well as the lateral lip of linea aspera. Insertion as quadriceps femoris tendon and the lateral border of the patella. Okay, then femoral nerve is the nerve supply. Action is extension at knee joint. Okay, there is one difference between the medial and the lateral attachment of these two muscles. Vastus medialis has got an extensive attachment on the medial border. Okay, that prevents lateral displacement of the patella. Okay, vastus lateralis is attached on the lateral border, but it is not extensive as compared to that of vastus medialis. Okay, that one point of difference you need to know. Then vastus intermedius arises from the anterior and the lateral surfaces of the femur. Okay, again quadriceps femoris tendon to the patella. Then nerve supplies femoral nerve. Action is extension at the knee joint. Okay, then let's see other muscles and the related applied anatomy. Then articularis genu. Okay, so some fibers from the anterior surface of the femur are attached to the suprapatellar bursa of the knee joint, that is referred to as articularis genu. Okay, nerve supplies again femoral nerve. Action is it pulls the suprapatellar bursa during extension of the knee. Okay, so it maintains the stable position of the suprapatellar bursa. And this muscle, tensor fascia lata, the lateral aspect of the iliac crest between anterior superior iliac spine and the tubercle of the iliac crest. Okay, insertion, it's in the iliotibial tract. Okay, that's the thickening of fascia lata on the lateral aspect. Nerve supply C, it's written superior gluteal nerve. Okay, so that is the reason why most of the books take it in the gluteal region, but anatomically it is seen in the anterior compartment. Okay, when we remove the fascia lata, lateral aspect, this muscle is seen. Okay, so action here is stabilization of the knee in extension. Okay, then applied anatomy of these muscles, sartorius is referred to as Taylor's muscle. Okay, because when tailors do the tailoring movements, they cause flexion of the hip as well as flexion of the knee. Okay, so sartorius is referred to as Taylor's muscle, and quadriceps femoris clinically is tested by extension at the knee joint. Okay, extension of the knee joint is to be tested. Then rectus femoris is which type of muscle is a very frequently asked question. The answer is bipinnate muscle. Okay, so if you see carefully the fibers of the rectus femoris, they come from each side to a central tendon. Okay, so that is a bipinnate muscle. Okay, and all muscles number wise have been identified here, and these numbers you can see from the superscripted numbers which are mentioned here. Okay, so this was about the muscles of the anterior compartment of the thigh. Now let's cover the muscles in the anterior aspect of the hip. Okay, in many books, this is not given as a separate compartment. These muscles have been described in the abdomen because the chief bulk of this muscle is seen in the posterior abdominal wall as well as the pelvic wall. Okay, only their tendons are coming here in the lower limb. okay, but they have major action at the hip joint, so that's why we are covering in the lower limb. Sauce major muscle is one muscle. Okay, first identify those muscles in this image. Okay, so if you see here, that's the lumbar vertebrae. It is arising from the lumbar vertebrae, all five lumbar vertebrae. Okay, it is going towards a part of femur called as the lesser trochanter. Okay, so sauce major is there, and there is one muscle, sauce minor also. Okay, and there is one muscle in the iliac fossa called as iliacus. Okay, these three muscles are present here. So just look at the origin of sauce major, transverse process of the lumbar vertebrae as well as the intervertebral disc. Okay, and adjacent bodies of vertebrae from T12 to L5. Insertion is on lesser trochanter of femur. Nerve supplies L1, L2, L3 spinal nerves. Action is flexion of the thigh at the hip joint. Okay. And sauce minor, intervertebral disc between T12 and L1 is the origin, and also adjacent part of their bodies. Insertion is at the iliopubic eminence. So where is the iliopubic eminence? If you see the medial border of the ilium, there is one elevation between the ilium and the pubis, that's referred to as iliopubic eminence. Okay, it's inserted there. Nerve supplies L1 spinal nerve, and it is a weak flexor. Okay, and many a times this is absent also. Okay, this may not be present. So this muscle is sauce minor and iliacus muscle. So see the origin, iliac fossa of the hip bone. Insertion is again lesser trochanter of the femur. Here also it was lesser trochanter. Okay, so as the sauce major comes down, it actually unites with the iliacus, and together they are also referred to as iliosauce. Okay, and here the nerve supply is femoral nerve. Action is flexion of the thigh at the hip joint. Okay, so these muscles have been identified here as different numbers. Okay, one is sauce major, two is sauce minor, and three is iliacus. Okay, then look at the applied anatomy. So there is one triangle called as lumbosacral triangle of Marsile. So where is this triangle present? You have to see in this area. Okay, this, supposing this is the L5 vertebrae, this is sauce major muscle, and there is a part of sacrum called as ala of the sacrum. Okay, there is one triangle which is forming here. Okay, similarly one triangle will form this side as well. Okay, so you can imagine this as a schematic diagram of the right sided sauce major and the right sided triangle. Okay, it is a triangular interval bounded by the body of L5. Then there is sauce major muscle, and inferiorly there is the ala of the sacrum. It contains many important neurovascular structures remembered by a mnemonic called as OILS, OILS, from lateral to medial. Okay, this mnemonic is from lateral to medial. So we can see the names of the structures which are mentioned here: obturator nerve, iliolumbar artery, lumbosacral trunk, and the sympathetic trunk. Okay, so many important structures are related here. So that's the lumbosacral triangle of Marsile. And sauce major, it gets involved in appendicitis. Okay, so what is this? Just see, when the appendix is retrocecal in position, it lies and irritates the right sauce major. Okay, and the forced extension of the thigh in such patient causes increase in pain in the right iliac fossa. Okay, so extension of the thigh will cause stretching of the sauce major, and the retrocecal position of the appendix, it actually lies on the sauce major, so it irritates that sauce major muscle. So that test is positive in appendicitis. Okay, the name of the test is sauce test. Basically, extension of the hip joint is done and the patient will complain of exaggerated pain. Okay, that is the basis of sauce test. Okay, so in this video we have covered two compartments, anterior compartment of the thigh as well as the anterior muscles of the hip. Okay, and in subsequent videos we'll be covering more content, and make sure you access these notes from the link which is given in the description box below, or you all can also scan this QR code. Okay, thank you.